Trip, trap, trip, trap.
Who's that tripping over my bridge? Roared the troll.
Oh, it's only I, $100 million worth of crypto, and I'm going over to another blockchain, it said in a very small voice.
Well, said the troll, I'm going to have to gobble you up then.
Yes, it's that time of the year in which we have to talk about another gosh darn crypto cross-chain bridge hack. It's hardly surprising, to be honest. In 2022 alone, we've already seen 20 mils, that from Ethereum scaling solution Optimism, a $320 million hack against Solana Bridge wormhole, and $625 million looted from Axie Infinity's Ronin Bridge. Now, with this latest attack, the total money lost has reached $1 billion this year. Indeed, on June 25th, tokens crossing Harmony's Horizon Bridge were snatched out of thin blockchain air. This particular bridge moves tokens from the Harmony blockchain to Ethereum, Binance chain, and the Bitcoin network, although Harmony reported that the Bitcoin section of the bridge was not affected. The long and short of it all, approximately $100 million was hijacked. The hacker managed to siphon off, and I warn you that this list is quite extensive, Ethereum, Binance Coin, Binance USD, DAI, Tether, USDC, Frax, Wrapped Ether, Wrapped Bitcoin, Aave, and Sushi. So yes, there are less cryptos in heaven and earth than have been pinched in this particular attack. The attackers managed to create this fine old mess thanks to Harmony Horizon cross-chain bridge requiring only two signatures out of the four available to authorize any arbitrary transaction. Which, FYI, isn't a lot if you consider the Ronin Bridge needed 5 out of 9 signatures to verify a transaction, although 4 of those were sitting under the same private key. So yes, maybe it is the same after all. According to Harmony founder Stephen Zay, the hacker just decrypted the private keys stored on Harmony's network, because apparently that's like a really easy thing to do, and then took control of 2 of the 4 multi-signature signers needed to commence the looting, and so commenced the looting. Gah! The amount of hacks is just too goddamn high. It's madness, even if there be method to it. I mean, can you imagine if every now and then in the real world, a few dozen cars crossing the Golden Gate Bridge just kind of fell through the tarmac and we all collectively went, ah, dang it, go get the paver back out, would you? It just wouldn't happen. So what is it with cross-chain bridges specifically? What's their deal and why are they so vulnerable to exploitation? The explain like on 5 summary is they have an unusually numerous amount of places in which they can be attacked. You can exploit through the depositing process, for instance, where an attacker will create a fake deposit, or exploit by bypassing validations needed on deposits. That latter option led to $325 million getting nicked on Solana's wormhole. If that isn't our nefarious Neo's particular cup of tea, he or she can decide to organize a validator takeover play, which no isn't an avant-garde Broadway production. It's where they'll take control of the signatures needed to authorize a transaction, which, if you've been paying attention to what I've been telling you, is exactly what happened in this case, and also with Axie Infinity's Ronin Bridge. These aforementioned angles of attack reflect a broader set of vulnerabilities compared to a smart contract platform on an individual chain, which is perhaps why even Ethereum founder Vitalik Buterin voiced his concerns over cross-chains. In a Reddit post, Vitalik outlined the risks of storing native assets on non-native chains as the security while hopping between sovereign blockchains is limited, leaving users potentially exposed to a 51% attack, which is basically a crypto term used to describe a malicious agent gaining control of more than 50% of a crypto supply. Instead, Vitalik advocates multi-chains, but that's a whole different video. It'd be like me trying to explain the plot of Ocean's 8 while you're still halfway through watching Ocean's 11.
But this is where it gets tricky.
So let's get to the fallout. In response to the attack, Harmony halted its Horizon Bridge and altered its Ethereum channel into a 4 out of 5 multi-signature validation system. Someone actually suggested they do this back in April, but then again, The Simpsons suggested Donald Trump was going to be president 16 years before he was, and no one paid them any attention either. Meanwhile, the protocol reached out to its cybersecurity partners and none other than the FBI, while also offering a bounty of $1 million for the hacker to return the stolen assets, which, if you know rudimentary math, is of course 1% of all the funds stolen. Peanuts, essentially. But let's not also forget the time the Poly network was hacked for $610 million and they offered a 0.08 return with a $500,000 bounty. I don't know. To me, offering this little is like a bank asking robbers for their money back in exchange for festive Christmas hampers with wine and chestnuts and those little sausages wrapped in bacon. Maybe I'm being too cynical though. $1 million, no strings attached, no constantly looking over your shoulder, worrying about the breadcrumbs to your true identity that you may have accidentally left somewhere out in the darknet and the FBI is now about to break down your door while you sleep. None of that. Doesn't sound too bad of a deal, but it seems it's not one the hacker is interested in. Having already sent all of their tokens to Uniswap to exchange them for ETH, and now with that ETH, they are sending it over to Tornado Cash, laundering it in staggered transfers. Let's broaden our horizons here for the conclusion. Basically, it's just really hard to imagine cross-chain bridges going anywhere. They're not going away, at least for now. Bridges like Harmony Horizon are becoming an important part of Web3, allowing developers to easily launch dApps across multiple blockchains, breaking down silos, which is all important as crypto space continues to go mainstream. But given there's around 70 cross-chains to choose from and over $20 billion in total value locked ready to seal, it's hardly surprising that they're a hotspot for these sort of hackers. Until better preventative measures are put in place across the board, it's unlikely we've seen the back of these bridge exploits, nor the trolls behind them. What do you think? Let's talk it over in the comments below, and do let us know if you like these crypto snaps, or feedback, comments, support, rants, pointing out things that don't work, pointing out things you like. All of it helps us make better videos in the future. Until next time though, look first, then leap.